Hello all of you beautiful people, welcome back to another video. Instead I've actually got a very different video. I'm gonna be talking about the whole Apple versus Epic game situations, because I want to talk about it and talk about my opinions and just kind of explain what's going on. Also, the reason why you're looking at the season 9 event in the background, obviously you can't see it at the moment, but you will be, because it's the only mobile footage I ever got. And you know, it's not on mobile anymore, because obviously I deleted it. I couldn't reinstall it and get any more, because it's banned. And I will be explaining why in this video. Now, it's going to work a bit differently from a lot of my other voiceovers, because I actually have notes I will be looking at. So you'll probably be hearing clicking of my mouse on my PC and all that. But other than that, we will be vibing. But without further ado, let's get into this. Now, this all started when Fortnite pretty much cut 20% of, I think it was 30% of their prices out of V-Bucks, which is actually a pretty decent amount. And on consoles and on PC, this made no difference. It's just, you buy it the exact same weight, it just costs less. However, in mobile, you will see, like, on the screen at the moment, that the different, it gave different ways to buy it. So you could buy it through Apple for the old price, or you get the new price, but you completely bypass Apple, and Apple get no money. This made Apple kick off, because this completely bypasses their, like, or obviously bypasses giving them money, and it's also against their terms and conditions, because if you remember, if you publish an app to the App Store, you have to, if any in-app purchases, and any, like, if you pay for the app, 30% of it go to Apple, and that's the only way you can buy things on Apple devices, or on mobile, Apple mobile devices. I think on a Mac it makes no difference. Pretty sure you can still play on a Mac if you have that. But if you are going through and buying stuff on your iPhone, you have to do it through the App Store. So this caused Apple to ban Fortnite completely, as they obviously broke terms and conditions. But Epic Games already had a plan for this. They knew that this was going to happen as soon as it happened, and they gave this put out this video pretty much as a retaliation against Apple.
Today we celebrate the anniversary of the platform unification directives. For years they have given us their songs, their labor, their dreams. In exchange, we have taken our tribute, our profits, our control. This power is ours and ours alone. We shall prevail.
Now, this video was actually a parody of a 1984 Apple Macintosh advert, which itself was a parody of, like, 1984, a novel by George Orwell. I will also be showing that right now.
Today we celebrate the first glorious anniversary of the Information Purification Directives. We have created, for the first time in all history, a garden of pure ideology, where each worker may bloom, secure from the pests of a contradictory force. Our unification of the force is more powerful a weapon than any fleet or army on earth. We are one people, with one will, one resolve, one cause. Our enemies shall talk themselves to death, and we will bury them with their own confusion. We shall.
On January 24th, Apple Computer will introduce Macintosh. And you'll see why 1984 won't be like 1984.
And in the news article I found here, I will leave a link to in the description. I will read out some important bits with screenshots on screen. Pretty much, it happened after Fortnite let players buy in-game currency at a lower rate, bypassing Apple. Epic knew this ban would come and filed a legal complaint just minutes after the removal, as Apple takes 30% cut from sales as standard. Hours later, Google also appeared to remove the app from Google Play, though you can still play it on Android phones, as there are other ways to download apps on Android. So you can still play it on Android if you have that, just not straight from Google Play. And those on an Apple Mac computer will not be affected, so yes, you are all safe. And then, in addition to tweeting legal complaint filed in California court, Epic also announced the imminent in-game screening of a short film titled 1980 Fortnite, which I just showed, and it'll play a play on George Orwell's 1984. The novel is about a dystopian society that controls citizens and tolerates no dissent. So, and it's also a parody of Apple's 1984 Macintosh advert. This is pretty much, this is being shown because, like, the whole 1984 thing about control, and it's pretty much saying that Apple forced people to buy from the App Store. And pretty much what Epic Games want is they want not just Fortnite, it's not about money, they're saying, because let's face it, they have enough money, but it's pretty much saying that they want people to have options. It's not fair that they can only get apps from the App Store. They want to have other ways to get to make purchases, pretty much. Shouldn't have to be through Apple. And then the owner and CEO of Epic Games also made couple of tweets. Tim Sweeney also made a few tweets that you'll see on screen now. At the most basic level, we're fighting for the freedom of people who brought smartphones to install apps and sources of their choosing. The freedom for creators of apps to distribute them as they choose, and the freedom for both groups to do business directly. The primary opposing argument is smartphone makers can do whatever they want, and that's an awful notion. Or we all have rights, and we all need to fight to defend our rights against whoever whoever would deny them, even if that means fighting a beloved company like Apple. Another argument against supporting hashtag #FreeFortnite is this is just a $1 billion company fighting a $1 trillion company about money. But the fight isn't over. Epic isn't wanting a special deal. It's about the basic freedoms of all customers and developers. Finally, there's nothing wrong with fighting about money. You all work hard to earn this stuff, and when you and you can spend it the way it's, you want to spend it. It's divided, determines whether your money funds a creation of games. Sorry, it doesn't stop swimming for games. Or taken by a middleman, whose power separate them from the games and creators. So pretty much, they're saying that. They want people to spend money how they want to spend it, and if they don't want their money to go to Apple, that's fair enough. They don't want their money to go to Apple, which I do agree with. And although Epic Games did straight up break the rules, I am on their side. I think it would be nice to have a cheaper option without Apple just taking a cut of the money. Ironic, because I do a lot of my videos with my phone, which is an iPhone, by the way. And another thing is that on Apple's side, they say that it's fair, everybody has the same treatment, when in reality, they don't, and that's what Epic Games are saying. It isn't fair on everyone, despite what Apple is saying. There are certain companies, I'm pretty sure Amazon is one of them, where Apple don't take any money, because you buy things from Amazon, for example. So why should other games developers or app developers have to do the same thing? But in my personal opinion, I am on Epic Games' side, and it is honestly quite a bummer that it is going to be removed off mobile, because that is, like, pretty sure it's 1 billion devices. Like, that's a lot of devices for Epic to just straight up take Fortnite away from. It is a big deal. And what, honestly, one of my pretty much one of my most memorable Fortnite gaming moments was sitting in that hotel room on my phone and watching the Fortnite Season 9 Monster vs. Mech event, as you're looking at in the background. I do hope that Epic Games win this war, and Fortnite can be brought back on the App Store. For any of you who do have Fortnite on your iPhones, you can still play it, but not for very long. The Fortnite, you'll be able to play it till the end of Season 3, Chapter 2, and that ends on Wednesday the 26th. And as I am recording it, it is already the 20th. So you have 6 days left to play Fortnite, and I'm pretty sure it won't get updates, and you will no longer be able to play it at all. If you had had Fortnite on your phone before, on your iPhones before, and you haven't anymore, when I went into my recently deleted apps, I could not find it there. It just straight up didn't come up. And if you search it up on the App Store, it's not there either. It was quite mad. It is really, like, it is a massive deal, not just for Fortnite and not just for Apple, but it's, like, gaming in general. Because if Fortnite, if Epic Games win this whole battle against Apple, that's going to change the way mobile gaming and the App Store and everything will work forever. And that is a big deal. And that's the end of this video. If you want to, I will be keeping you all updated if you follow my Instagram, x888zx. I have a story highlight named hashtag free Fortnite. All the updates will be posted there and on my story. So if anything new pops up, go and check that out, and I'll keep you updated there. And then if anything really huge happens, I'll probably do another video in probably about a month or two, whenever this gets resolved or whatever happens. So yeah, thank you all for watching. If you liked it, cheers, and I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye.